Ready?
Yeah.
Yo, we here, man. Stack
you know what
hours.
Time it is.
March 28th, 2017. Whack ass Tuesday, but we about to make lit. Couple more drinks. That's more.
Shit, always raining, snowing, doing something confusing on our night and shit, but that's a fact to have y'all stay inside the crib so we could get some of this news, man.
Niggas had like two good Tuesdays, and one good Tuesday was like,
shit was
weird, shit was crazy.
Snacks After Hours, powered by Success, the best thing happening on Tuesday. Let's go.
A lot of crazy shit happened, man. This nigga Fetty Wap, his people got in a little altercation. Andy Up, yap that fool. A lot of things went down. I don't know.
Oh,
man.
The niggas took his things?
Took his joint, B. Nigga said, what happened? Niggas followed niggas to the deli. Long story short, some pistol whipped him. One of his men from his camp. It was got beat up, jump. And then, what happened? Son chopped off the pistol. As he chopped off the pistol, nigga shot himself.
Shot himself. He did a plexico verse on the shit.
Then shot out shoot. He did hit two of the ops, though. He did hit two of the ops. That was word.
After he shot himself?
After he shot himself. And then, 4 years told us that the nigga was rocking the chain, got locked up.
Cause why? All right, now here's the thing. So now a nigga gets away with the chain.
Yeah.
I understand it's a rapper's chain. But you throw the picture up on the gram.
That's
like,
stitching on yourself. Why are you throwing any
yourself.
Pictures?
You,
I'm trying to go straight to a jeweler and melt that chain and get that chicken.
Let me get this right.
That's the only though. I don't want to have no trophies. I don't want to wear it. I don't need that bad karma. Give me the bread.
I tell you though, man, diamond might poke the stones out and shit. But you know what I'm saying? We melting that jewel now, man.
Shout out to Sierra Leone, man. Yeah. Blood diamonds. Those loud blood diamonds, man. Really, because they got shot.
I don't understand. Like, where does these niggas get their code of like how they do their shit? This shit is crazy.
That's crazy.
This shit is crazy.
My thing is like, why would you even want to rob, you feel me? A star, like, you feel me? Old cameras on him, like, you know he gonna snitch.
Nah, you know what it is? He just be so heavy jeweled up. They know he can't see from one side. You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
just,
he got one eye view.
I mean, listen. You gotta like somebody that's trying to get somebody.
Fact.
So the nigga like, all
right. So you gonna go from the right hand side, the good eye side, or the bad eye side?
You gonna come from the bad eye side? You know what I'm gonna take him a while. Yeah, the blind side. He got the super blind side.
Damn.
You know what I'm saying? It's but we talking about criminal shit. You know what I'm saying? It's terrible, man, but...
And the chain was worth $350,000.
Wow.
And the dude took it, said, Fetty, it's not about...
So he took a picture.
How?
Damn. He took that $350,000. That's more than a quarter mil.
I'm just thinking, like...
That's a house in the car. And some change.
That's like robbing a bank. You gotta sit on that for a little while. You gotta... You gotta get somebody that could flip that out for you. Like it's not
saying it's fake, posting it, saying it's fake.
It's like how would you get rid of that? You know, you understand what I'm saying?
Nah, I go straight to the Diamond District, took it to the jewelry.
Right, and you gonna take it?
I don't know. I saw it on the floor. I picked it up. I don't know who it is. Shout out to Guns. Guns is in the building.
Yeah, yes, shout out to Chris Guns. You already know.
Yo, Guns.
You get the drum roll when you get in
the building. Pal's in the building. Yo, Pal, what's your Instagram?
Oh, shit. Oh, man.
I'm saying,
Pal on the spot.
You in the cut. They can't see you.
Pal Productions.
Shout out to Pal. Millio's in the building.
Yeah.
Pal Productions. Follow that Pal Productions. Follow that Millio. Millio's in the building. Wavelength.
Yeah, Millio in the building.
Follow that Guns. We shooting. Yo, yeah. That's the motto, bro. We shooting. Yo, that's crazy. Follow that stands at NYC, CB Holloway, that does Diamonds NYC, that New Prince City.
You already?
Yeah.
That Success Radio.
SoundCloud, Des Diamonds.
Shit is crazy. Drake sold 550,000 first week. Rick Ross sold 100,000.
Who's
really the boss?
Did y'all hear crickets just now? I heard the crickets.
No, but who's really the big boss? If Drake is doing 505.
Nah, but hold on, how does it work? So listen, so basically he sold five times as much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he's signed under somebody.
Three niggas.
Under three niggas. So then that split, that split three more ways. So he's still a little bit up. Because yeah. Ross
is his own boss.
He's his own boss. But I understand
what you're saying. Units.
I understand what you're saying. I mean, Drake doing numbers, man. First week, that's a good look. You know what I mean?
But you saw me the more than life. That's like a Jamaican term, something like that.
Oh, that's the name of his album, right? More Life. Like more that's life. The only thing I got with Drake, man. I don't know. He just keeps stealing a lot of Jamaican shit.
And he's a culture vulture. Oh, he said Rihanna.
Yeah, I mean Rihanna. Rihanna has a lot to do with that, but and she's I don't in think his ear. So. Yeah. It's a lot of him, man. If you notice on a lot of his tracks, at the end of the track, you got like a little 30-second reggae segment.
Right.
So it's
right.
Like, check it out. What I'm figuring, I don't know how they money go or they exchange go, but I'm figuring it's like if I sold him the track and I was like, boom, he bought the verse or whatever, or he bought the hook. Mm-hmm. So now me, I would probably think he's putting the hook throughout the song.
Right, right.
But after signing the agreement, if I now hear my shit and the hook is at the exact end of the song, contractually, he filled his obligations. But me, I'm so feeling
saying,
beat.
You saying that he just taking a beat, took you off the chorus and all that, and just jacking the beat for 30 seconds.
Yeah, it puts you at the end of the joint where you're not really in association with the song. You're just actually at the end of
the
song.
Wait, is the focus on the song or is the focus not on
the song? I mean, no, the point being is you would do it because you want the airplay. But if all the DJs is mixing the song after it hits 2 minutes, they're never gonna hear your part.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? If when the credits for the album come out, he doesn't give you the credit. Hashtag popcorn. If he doesn't give you the your credits on the joint, like what are you doing it for?
You know what I'm saying? Recently, in the crib, Safari didn't get paid for Paint Print.
He beefing about a lot of shit that he ain't get paid for. But you know what I'm saying? I think Safari was just happy to rub shoulders. At the time, I think he was just getting up and the money was getting up. And if you notice all the pictures, I'm noticing like he said, because I would think he got paid.
Yeah.
But if you notice all the pictures, he jeweled up, different jewels all the time. So I think Nikki was paying him in jewels. I think she's painting them in rented jewels and shit like that. Man. You might never know how this shit go down, man.
Funny thing, I'm on the gram.
Painting them with some rented jewels, right? I'm saying it could be, bro.
I'm on the gram earlier. And
yo, guys, back to that Drake shit. Oh, he sampled a Tony Yayo track, number 2. And he threw him on the album.
All right, so my man ain't got a mic, but he's saying, like, on Drake, you know what I'm saying? That shout out to Casanova. You know what I'm saying? That he did some sampling.
Yeah. From my understanding, Drake is an archiver. He trying to take it back to the old hip hop. He hanging out with cats to get the
approval.
Right. If you hang out with them, you get it fast approved. Like he hanging out with Sade and J Lo.
Sade and J Lo don't get no improvements. If you want improvement, you come to the Bronx.
He's trying to clear the sample.
Clear sample. Come to the hood.
Pay signature rather than going through managers.
I already know I should go to the publisher.
I think he's more than just a culture vulture. I think he's more like a style soaker, like a sponge ass nigga. Like
Shang Tsung.
At the end of the day, when you in like, if you in a room with this guy, he'll probably show you how cool he is just to get you talking. Mm-hmm. And then the next thing you know, he got your swag on a song. I believe it's totally like that. And then, you know, me from being Jamaican, that's like another big situation. I think I spoke about it before as far as the beats that's being taken from a lot of the reggae artists. He's taking all the actual reggae beats. And what was happening is, he's using these reggae beats and not putting reggae on it.
Right.
So that's effectively damaging the shit that you would hear firsthand coming from the island, because these beats are basically sold out. He has the lockdown on these beats. So now you're not going to hear, if you like reggae, you won't hear 5 different reggae artists on one joint.
naturally.
You won't hear that because he got the joint locked down. That's why he had a problem with the dude. What's the dude that he made a song? He made like the song on the same beat.
Who?
Tory Lanez.
Okay, right.
Now,
right,
see,
right,
Tory
right.
Lanez made the same song on the same beat. Now, culturally, yeah. That's what we do. Jamaican, you might hear one beat, and you might hear five different artists on one beat.
On the rhythm.
Right, on the rhythm, exactly. He had a problem with that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But this is
honestly, me personally, if I bought the joint, you know, and you rock on my beat, I feel like, yeah, you're doing too much, because yeah. I bought the joint.
Yeah, but it's a lot of stuff, man. It's not wrong being a culture vulture.
But don't get mad at niggas culture vulturing you.
Yeah, yeah, but don't be a style soaker. Don't have somebody that doing less than you and soak his style up because you got the fame. That's whack.
That's whack.
That's whack. You know what I mean?
Yo, we about to go to a little song segment of the.
Yeah, honestly, it's raining hard, right? As hell outside, right? You see, we just started drinking some tea.
Bucket, right.
You know, we gotta listen up for the show, man. It's Snacks After Hours, man. It's powered by Success, man. See what it is, man. Success Clothing NYC. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Casanova, Chris Guns, all the fam in the building. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Melio. Shout out to all the homies in the building, man.
Yeah, man.
Pal, man. Pal, shout out too, bro. You know what I mean?
Pal,
I see
low.
What you do. You putting
Pal
the,
say, yo,
Pal putting the work in right now.
$500.
Yeah, so we gonna get into a couple of joints and shit. I don't know what you wanna hear first, bro, cause I know we be trying to soak their ears up with this thing, man.
Oh, go to Michael Jackson joint.
I was gonna say the same thing.
Michael Jackson, I gotta hear that.
Yeah,
again,
man.
Bro. Listen, man. It was a room full of people. You know how it'd be a room full of people you really wanna hear.
Yeah,
something.
Yeah. You can't get
now
to really
that
hear
time,
it.
On a rainy day like today.
Matter of fact, since it's a rainy day today, now I mean, I think what we should do, after we come back a little later on in the show, I think we're gonna premiere another new joint that we got. Ooh. And shit. I think we might as well just hit him with the pieces hitting and shit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we gonna, all right, Melio, we doing that on deck, right? We gonna hit them with the pieces hitting. But right now, we gonna go
like
to Michael
sound.
Jackson, She Bad. You know what I'm saying? Sleepy Holloway, Des Diamonds. You already know. We gonna hit him with the part two pieces hitting in like the next half hour and shit.
Title.
So you already know. Yeah, now that title is, you know what I mean? When you hear the song, you know what we talking about. You know what I mean? So listen, Snacks After Hours. Powered by Success.
Some hitters on it, that Billie Jean jacket on, with no zippers on it. I fuck with the world. I got some Are they hating? Bitch shaking.
Her money.
Money
right,
I'ma
make you. Sleepy Holloway, ready to go.
Yeah, they hating on me. Big ass, she shaking on me. Street been waiting on me. Step out, I'm looking on me. Yeah, they color me free. My favorite was color is free. Your bitch keep looking at me. Cause all of my niggas is free. Say all of my niggas. All of my niggas, all of my niggas is free. Say all of my niggas, all of my niggas, all of my niggas is free. Say all of my bitches, all of my bitches, all of my bitches is free. Say all of my, all of my niggas, all of my niggas is free. Nigga, call me Flea. Shout out to Cameron. Got cheap stuff, top, get your pen on. Some chip for back, been wrong. Know these lames and they looking like stand wrong. No pun intended. This shit is a big pun intended. Yeah, Boogie Down Productions, bitch wants something, I give her deductions. Married to the money, now currently cuffing. Started from nothing, stumbled on something.
Start from the bottom,
flow hotter than the number 9. Dope talk for the shivers all in your mind. CB Hollow, keep the hollow, yeah, hollow mind. Killing everybody, think this shit is Caliban. Start late, finish first, call that round time. She came first, finish last, call that round time. Yeah, they hitting on me.
Me,
big ass, she shaking on me.
Shake.
Streets been waiting on me.
They waiting on.
Step out, I'm looking on flip. Yeah, they color me flip. My favorite was color is green. Your bitch keep looking at me. Cause all of my niggas is flee. Say all of my niggas. All of my niggas. All of my niggas is flee. Say all of my niggas.
All of my niggas.
All of my niggas. All of my niggas is flee. Say all of my bitches. All of my bitches. All of my bitches is flee. Say all of my. All of my niggas. All of my niggas is flee.
Next move criminal. MJ. With the hawk, play the black, let the Kembe. Bunch of Daniel sons, I'm your sensei. Well known in my town, Caliente. Why I act like this? Me a clock on the wrist. See the price for the bottle, nigga, that ain't shit. When I'm done with the club, then it's back to them bricks. Package it up, then it's back to the strip. Hacks where I'm from, where them savages live. Hammers go off every night under dig. If you slow for the bucks, you end up on the bus. Driving the foreign to my. When I get it, gotta spend it. Red eye, red line, I'll be pushing to the limit. Act like this, cause I'm talking how I live it. Opinions never matter, they influenced by the critics. I'm influenced by the business.
Yeah, they hitting on me. Big ass, she shaking on me. Streets been waiting on me. Step out, I'm looking on flip. Yeah, they color me flip. My favorite was color is free. Bitch keep looking at me. Cause all of my niggas is free. Say all of my niggas. All of my niggas. All of my niggas is free. Say all of my niggas. All of my niggas. All of my niggas is free. Say all of my bitches. All of my bitches. All of my bitches is free. Say all of my. All of my niggas. All of my niggas is free. Niggas.
Out of fucking problem, man. Be smooth, flim dot. We love all types of bitches. You name them.
Yeah, I like the fucking, got a fucking problem. I love bad bitches, got my fucking. shit out like it. Then I know that you alright. Yeah, I got something special playing tonight. I gotta loosen you up, cause I know the thing is tight. Let's hit the spot, let's sip a drink and then disappear. I want you all on myself, I thought I'd just make it clear. The next stop is the crib, I call it the player's lair. I lay your style of physique, I swear you ain't playing fair. As emotion constantly builds, the time is near. For the love and the start, I love to hit from the rear. She says she likes when I'm rough, allows me to pull her hair. I like shorty, she's tough, her attitude's never scared. Shorty's eternal, she knows I'm glad and I came prepared. My favorite game, if you like, let's play it, it's the game. I love them back shots, love the way that ass drops. The way she got me feeling like I hit the jackpot.
In the air now, she suspended. Oh, her shoes mean like a grin. And I make a purr like my engine. Yeah, that's the Hemi. All about those Benji. She need more Dior, nickname her Demi. She don't fuck with wine, she go straight for the Henny. I'ma flirt, make her hurt, squirt like a semi. Many niggas tryna holler, but I bag it up. I'm all about the money, they pockets ain't added up. She love when I spank it for acting up. And since a juvenile, we ain't told her to back it up now.
After you back it up, man. Swap, swallow the whole cock, like, after you pack it up, then stop, swap, swallow the whole cock, like.
I love bad bitches, got my fucking problem. And yeah, I like the fuck, I got a fucking problem. I love bad bitches, got my fucking problem. And yeah, I like the fuck, I got a fucking problem. I love bad bitches, got my fucking problem. And yeah, I like the fuck, I got a fucking problem.
Finding somebody real is your fucking problem. Bring your girls to the crib, maybe we can solve it.
Steph Curry, right, yeah. Where the hell are they? Steph Curry, hit him with the three. Steph Curry, where the hell are they?
The hell are
Steph
they?
Curry, hit him with the three. True to this, nah, I never knew of this. With the look, ain't felt like Julius. True to this, nah, I never knew of this. With the look, ain't felt like Julius. Where the hell are they? Steph Curry, hit him with the three. Steph Curry, where the hell are
they?
With the rock, like Jordan with the rock, huh?
on the pot, bruh. They kill me on that block, bruh. Reggie with the shot, bruh.
With this shot, you Stephon.
high again. I feel like Leviathan. They calling my phone up to buy again. They call me a supplement. No, I got the plug, I got the plug. Drama down with scars, come with scars. I get it from the mud, from the mud. They gon' pay me in blood, pay me in blood. I'm high again. I feel like Leviathan. They call up my phone up to buy again. Who you call me a supplement? Rollin' and smoking on
Sex after hours.
I'm a little bit more lit on the litter meter.
Definitely.
That's word.
Definitely. The meter done turned up a little bit.
That's word.
Powered by success.
We here,
clothing,
man.
Clothing NYC.
Stands in NYC. Des Diamond NYC.
Yes, sir.
That's word. The recap. Fetty Wap. Chain got robbed.
Yes. It's
worth $350.
$350. Niggas gotta get that on the black market.
That's probably like 150, 100.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, is to take a little time, you know.
But that's thick Cuban too.
Now you break that shit down. What you do, you poke the stones out, and then you piece by piece that. But anyway, you know, other than that, so they did it that.
His man shot himself. They shot two ops. The op got the chain, went on Instagram where he got locked up. Shit is crazy. Drake. More life, so found it 5,000.
More life.
Before so 100,000.
This nigga's crazy, week. Man.
McKinnon,
he ain't out with the Jamaicans, man.
McKinnon responded to Migos, because Migos made a statement talking about McKinnon is not official. He recently came out, you know, saying that he's out of the closet, he's gay and shit.
Oh, Migos. McKinnon, the same dude that was writing a couple joints for OVO.
Got lupus disease?
Yeah, on the Sunday, on the Tuesday. It's going up.
I knew something was up, because nothing go up on Tuesday. So something was funny.
Yeah, they canceled his contract on a Wednesday. Yeah. That shit's so wild.
The Migos said that basically, how official can you be if you get, how you trap out the bando? If you feel me, doing niggas hand shit.
Yeah.
That's work.
Yeah.
That's just crazy.
So, I mean.
Funny thing is, though, I knew someone was looking. A nigga had the head with the wig.
Yeah.
Like, how's that?
I mean, but at least he honest to himself. I don't know if he got a bag on the rest of them niggas up in there. I don't know.
Let's talk about Christina Milian's first type. Got Christina Milian first.
Who? The Cannon? No, not Nick Cannon. McCannon. Nigga made going up Tuesday.
Snacks after hours.
McCannon. So Migos was like, yo, how official can he be if he, feel me? Talking about trapping Molly, ain't some Molly no more and all this. And feel me?
Yo.
Doing a queer eye for straight guy shit.
Oh, no, man. That whole shit is crazy.
But he responded back to them. He was like, yo, how can he be perpetrating fraud when they was doing songs together? When he was doing songs together, everything was good. Mm. Now they up, and now it's like they trying to separate themselves from him.
Right.
But I'm like, the chorus for the song they did was Teach Me How to Whip It. What was they really whipping?
Whoa.
Yo, that's Big Cannon and Omigos.
Yeah, that's a song they did with
that's
the Migos.
Chorus. Teach me how to whip it. What was they whipping? Yo,
man, Success NYC, right? SuccessRadio.com, right?
Yo, what's next, Paco? Paco, what you got to say, Paco?
No, about WAC 100 that he ran up on the Migos.
Oh, he ran up on the Migos?
Oh,
yes,
sir. Yo, Paco be honest, son.
Yeah. We gotta get that verified. Yo, yeah. That verified. Let's see what's going on.
We got somebody to get right on it right away.
She was on rap on the Migos.
Shout out to the nigga that get right on it right away.
Yeah, Paco, brand new news.
Yeah.
Kevin Gates not getting released. He served 180 days for gun charge. Yeah, he got warrant and Chirac.
Yo, Kevin Gates, he having all this bad luck, man.
He got warrant and Chirac for gun charge.
Gun charge, man. Yeah. Like,
but I don't get why.
I tell you though, it's like, they showing other stuff, man. But if you look at how Chirac is, you wouldn't go there and wouldn't really protect yourself.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Gun.
All the niggas that you rolling with wouldn't be doing that. So it's like an open act. Once police see
and
you,
me personally, I feel like it's only depending on how serious the case is. Cause I done had plenty of time I went in court and they like, you know, you got warned. I'm in the Manhattan, and like, you know, I got warned the Bronx, right? Yeah. Go handle that. Get out of here. I'm like, thank you, Judge. Well, I will not handle that.
That's right. Police, that's the time now. You ain't going nowhere.
Yeah, they wait. All that comes out. When your fingerprints go through the system, everything comes out. Everything. But no, it's the paperwork.
Now
somehow paperwork.
Doing it from their phone.
The paperwork, yeah.
Before they leave the arrest site. In other words,
the paperwork take a little longer to come back for certain situations. That's word. But he going to get transferred to Cook County Jail. May take him 30 days to get transferred from today.
Man.
So now, like, he's out of jail. And take 30 days to get transferred.
Or just for that warrant or just to fight that case?
No, take him 30 days to get transferred from the jail that he's in to Chicago.
Oh, okay.
Because he in Florida.
Yeah.
So the extradite. Extradite. So right now he's doing.
Give him a bail or not?
Yeah. Everybody's saying he's going to get the bail because more than likely the judge is going to be lenient knowing that he's an artist and the shot rack and his, you know, just the gun crazy. What do you call it? Gun crazy state?
It's up there, right? They got the number one
crime and
murder rate.
It takes them 30
listen,
days to
right
get
now, everybody lit in the studio. I'm going to start with that right there.
Nah, I think I'm the only sober one
here. Facts. Mike's ex-wife was 109,000 for social support.
That's real crazy. That's real crazy.
A year's not bad. 109,000 for a year? Wait. Matter of fact, it's for a month.
A month.
If you think about it, I think certain things should be added into, you know what I'm saying, what she get. What, 109?
That's too much.
That shit is not
worth it. Snack after hours.
I think she wasn't shooting him.
That's a fact.
That's worse. She wasn't shooting the gym. Like,
She wasn't with him when he was shooting in the gym, man. That's
but they broke up after 10 years, and she's saying, yeah, she broke up after 10 years, and she's saying that but she this needs is, money for vacation.
But this is the whole clause.
Yeah.
Shout out to V12 Vita.
Yo, you wanna pull up right there?
Of course.
Yo, Paco, can you switch with V12?
Yeah, please.
Because
yeah.
The camera can see that she's V. Shout out to V12 in the building.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Pull up right there. Come on, son. I think forever. Get comfortable.
Yeah.
Shout out to
that weather, man. That shit has people
running. Shout out Paco already.
Yo. But,
everybody knows Vito Vita. Let's give a hand clap for Vito Vita. Come on.
You better stop it, y'all.
Shout out Vito. Nah,
put the headphones on. Put the headphones on.
Yo, so like, whatever we talking about.
So what's the topic?
Yeah, Mike Epps.
So Mike, wife, 109,000. Wife, she want 109,000
for spousal support. She said she's too old to work. They've been together for 10 years.
I hear that.
And while he was doing his thing, he was encouraging her not to work.
Okay, she got a lot of points there.
Wow.
10 years. That's a lot of years. I deal with your bullshit.
But isn't it
a
death do you part thing?
Like, that's a lot.
Isn't it a death do you part? Like,
oh yeah, definitely. So who wanna leave who?
Apparently,
it doesn't matter. It's but do you think she's supposed to get that? Like, I wanna get that right there.
She is entitled to that.
She's entitled to that.
That's nothing. He got money.
No, he makes 3.5. million for the year.
Yeah.
What she want?
Hold on. What
she's?
No, no, no. She wants 109,000 a month. My
right.
Fault.
Total is 1.3
million a year.
A million a year.
So
that's
she trying to get him.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
How many kids they got?
I think they have 2 kids.
They have a lot of kids.
2 or 3 kids. You know,
and it's 72,000 for private school. She broke it down.
Yeah. She got technical.
She broke it down.
She want money.
She said 72,000 for private school. 3,500 for a nanny. 600 for the Benz.
Yeah, for her Benz.
She's for her Benz.
She's expensive.
And vacations.
I don't know, that's right. That's right. I mean, 10
years kids.
Yeah.
Right? He did not want her to work at all.
Right.
The judge is going to be like, listen, since you didn't want her to work.
Right.
Now she gave her that lifestyle.
Now, I might not be able to hit Mike 40.
He's right.
But what
he's, the fact that, my fault, what you saying, bro?
Nah, I'm saying they might not be able to hit Mike 40. But what he was saying was,
he's saying that basically, if you get married and you come into money, you got to support the lifestyle that you came into the situation with. So if I get married right now, and let's say next year I'm making $20, $30 million with my wife, she's entitled to half that bread because she was with me from the come up. Now, right. If I get married, if she get married into money, it's a different story because you got married into a situation where I was getting money already.
So you mean to tell me they wasn't together before he got the
no,
money?
No, they was together before,
the, together money. Before oh, okay. The money.
So she's definitely getting that bread.
Oh, yeah.
Now,
it's over for that nigga.
My thing is, right, and I don't know what it is, we can have the research professional over here.
Web 100. Know,
shout out, Castle. We could actually find out because... Yeah. I think something with the married ladies.
Yeah.
I think if they're actually in the marriage and 10 years is actually a significant number more than just being 10. Mm-hmm. I think it's a legal term where once you do the 10 years,
yeah.
You automatically, I think even if you had a prenup, you automatically get a certain amount of money.
It also depends
what
state you're in.
So what I'm trying to say is...
That's the X factor.
Did she wait until they reached 10 years?
I hear you.
Just like a lot of people, a lot of other, like they said, Michael Jordan, like a lot of people's wives in the industry did. In what's he call it? So you think it might be that situation?
You guys think she's for the money?
Nah, honestly, once you got the kids and all that, you feel me?
She's entitled.
Shit get different. But see, a nigga like me, I'm smart. This is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get that bread. I'm gonna make sure I get a business with my wife, couple business with my wife, right. And she gonna get that bread.
Right.
And my business is her gonna be very lucrative, where she gonna be making more money than me. Now I need half. How many to start money?
How yeah. I feel? It's
we'll
about.
Money.
It's about.
Now I need half.
If I'm Mike Epps, I'm gonna give it to her, but it's gonna be for a certain amount of time, not for life. So we gonna, you want this money, I'm gonna give it to you.
Yeah,
but
so
I'm gonna give it for 5 years. You're gonna sign this contract. You're gonna get that money for 5 years, and that's it.
So 40's saying give her the money, give her the 5 years money, sign her off. I'm saying I'm gonna see, we're gonna be seeing a lot more Mike Epps new movies coming out because he's gonna be working hard.
I'm saying he has to grind extra hard so she could get half of that. That shit don't even sound right. He has to grind extra hard so he could keep most of his money. Like, that shit don't even sound right. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, right? Why should it cost you? I understand about the private school based on where you live at.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because your kids will be targeted public school otherwise, which is still going to be targeted in private school. But, all right, so you get this private school. You're telling me that's the you can't get a cheaper private school? You're telling me that it takes $3,500 to watch some rich-ass kids?
$3,500
a month
for nothing. Divide that. What the phone that? Wait. Do that. $3,500 by four. How much is that? That's 800 a week. A little bit more than 800 a week. That's not bad. That's not bad.
That's reasonable.
800 a week is not bad.
The kids entitlement, that's there.
3,200. That's 3,200
okay. All right. So with the money and stuff like that, it comes into what, the vacations? That's
vacations
where
extra.
That's where the big money is extra. And rest.
But like she said, if you come into the lifestyle a certain way, you got to continue off. So you come in luxury, you have to continue off of luxury. Just ended with Nas, and Nas had a situation with his baby
mom,
Jay-Z B.
That if you're in a situation and then you become divorced, I think you have to scale back down automatically because you're not actually with the person anymore. So even if you was living up to his $3.5 million a year,
yeah.
So now you asking for 1.3, so you have to scale down anyway, right? I think that's the whole process in general, that you just supposed to scale the fuck down.
Or,
you know,
like Ab should be spending so spurgeonly with her, because I'll be like, well, Judge, we living on a certain budget. I'm making all this money, but we just living on a 40, 50 rack budget a month.
No, but but listen, how does it feel when you work so hard, you've been in there, you finally, after working so hard behind the scenes and then get in the game, then to be working extra hard, finally getting another wave of what you're trying to do going on, and then somebody tells you that whatever you make this year, you have to give somebody else that you half.
But that 3.5, is it before or after taxes?
That's true.
Because if it's before taxes, that 1.3 is outrageous.
Well, what Mike Foley said is, you know what I'm saying, is absolutely true. But what she's asking for is definitely going to be before taxes. She's not asking for taxed money. She's asking for money to pay for this and that, and whatever is left off of the, what you call it, is what she expects.
Okay, so this is just an offer. This is not what she's getting.
This is what they're actually going to court for. Yeah, she's demanding.
Okay.
This is the first demand.
I'm just saying, I don't know.
I mean, she could demand all she wants, but it's up to the judge.
Facts.
So she could get her whole.
And what state they are in. That's the main thing. If the state that's more lenient to him, she ain't getting that. The state that's more lenient to her,
facts,
she's getting that. So whatever state they in,
favor.
I think it's Chirac also, I'm not sure.
But the judge could tell her, get a job.
Facts.
That's it. The kids are gonna get this amount of money.
Right, and that's that. Right. So she could say
I think what Mike Forty is saying, the judge could tell her to get a job. Shout out to everybody in the building. Snacks After Hours.
Is Kevin Federline really winning?
No, Kevin Federline. Why I said that, I was talking earlier, and we were saying basically, Kevin Federline is basically the only dude. Shout out to all the other dudes that we don't know about. But Kevin Federline is probably the only dude that boned a celeb, got a couple babies out of her, married her, she divorced, and she pays him the bread. He gets a lot. Yeah, because he had, you know, a certain lifestyle. And right now, I think there's probably a lot of women groups that want to kill him.
Facts.
Because you know, he did. He, you know, shout out to Kevin Feld.
He the right.
But
thing.
You know what I'm saying. Right. So if you feel good about it, you know what I mean. But I don't know. I think he don't deserve to get a lot of her money. I think he's supposed to go back to how he was. Turn his hat backwards. I think he feel like that. But go back to dancing. But you know what I'm saying. He realized what was entitled to him based on the law and what these ladies been getting. So he did it. So I mean, we gonna research and find out whoever else did it. But do you think it's fair? I don't think it's right.
Life Yo, man.
Fair. Yeah, life is not fair.
And listen, realize who you having these babies with.
Hello. Know the bitch. Yeah. For 10 years and married. Yeah. Especially if you getting major money.
Listen, yeah.
Bitch, I'm moving real slow. I'm
marrying you after I get the bread.
Hello. You stick around, bitch.
Yes, sir.
Stay strong. How about we're a couple?
Right.
Cause you know what I'm saying? You see, that's why they made a lot of them laws, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Melio in the building. You know what I'm saying? That's why they made a lot of those laws, I think. You know what I'm saying? Now we sipping tea and talking about that tea, right? You know, let's say after you've been with somebody that you're not married to for 7 years or something like that, you are actually...
It's common law. After
common law or something like that. You see, they created that shit.
Right.
For everybody. That was like, nah, I ain't getting married. She like, yo, why you? Nah, I ain't getting married. Nah, I'm good. I ain't getting married. So they created that law for everybody that was like that, that been in a relationship.
Oh, you're talking about 7 years? Common law joint?
Yeah.
That shit rocking, bitch.
That's not right.
You know what I do? I break up in a 6 year.
You
get back next year. Let's start over again. Wait, we break up in 6 years, 11 months? So time break up.
So, well,
I won't be with you, bitch.
No. I ain't like, yo, listen, you been doing some shit lately. You know what I'm saying?
That's word.
I'm fucked. I've been with my girl. Not say fucked.
12
years already.
Wow. Yeah, man. So
she's taking half of everything.
Oh,
I know,
man.
That's right. She deserves it,
that
though.
That shit is real.
Now,
on
we,
serious note.
Yeah, we've been laughing and shipping jokey and shit. So we just really wanted to take it there. But on a serious note and shit.
Tom Brady, Jersey, got more media coverage than 38 people have been missing in D.C. It says 13 or 12 or 14 or something like that.
38 people.
Was 38 or more.
Missing in D.C.
What's going on in D.C.?
What's going on in D.C.?
It's saying young black, that young black teams, females.
Couple of Hispanic teams, too, in there.
Hispanic,
you know what I'm saying? And what I basically heard in the media coverage, and part of the media coverage was, they said they willfully left.
Yeah.
It,
38.
I want to be exact on the term that they said, because basically what they were trying to say was they weren't witness to an abduction. Because when somebody see that you're abducted, then it's different. So they basically say willful left, but that's a wrong statement. That just means that there was no witnesses to the abduction, because these people are factually missing.
Fact.
They have a term referenced critically missing. You know what I'm saying? And there was a young lady about 3 years ago, a little girl.
Relisha Rudd, if I'm not mistaken.
Relisha Rudd, which she had basically got missing, and there wasn't enough police attention or media coverage. Now, why, when an Amber Alert goes off, you know what I'm saying? Why have I not heard an Amber Alert for any child in Washington? Why have my Amber Alert haven't gone off? Why?
But, do you think it has to do with the government?
But no, it definitely, I feel.
It could be, they might think some of them are runaways.
Nah, none of them.
Listen. On a serious note, they think people are runaways, but I think it's the system. I think it's the process of everybody knows what's going on. You know, I'm gonna get right to the square root facts. Listen, this is Snacks After Hours, right? And we sipping tea. I'm getting real serious right now, but I'm dead ass serious though, right? I'm looking dead ass into the camera because I'm serious right now, right? The oldest existing body that was found, right? What's her name?
Lucy.
Lucy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That they made the movie with white girl. It was a black lady, right? It was black.
That Lucy
the oldest existing man that was found was black.
Yeah.
right?
Yeah, yeah.
This is the reason why they're taking the organs from our children. Mm-mm. Because the purity, you understand what I'm saying? And guess who's taking them? Everybody that has money. It's not European even, no, white, is Israel, is Jewish rabbis. Years ago in Brooklyn, where all those teens was missing, because you remember it was 14 girls at one time that was missing from Brooklyn, from the Crown Heights area. That was, and then later on, what was the thing? It was
7 years ago. New Jersey had a big bus with judges, rabbis, senators. They had a big bus for an organ trafficking case that was linked straight to Israel. And couple of broken the deal was from rabbis from Brooklyn.
Right. So this is something that happened. You know, I used to work in a hospital where I know people that used to steal hospital material and sell it to third world countries for a better deal. So if it works like that with simple staples that staple you up, it works like that with the organs that you have in Saudi. When you sign that organ donor card,
that's it.
They come for your organs that day you die.
Facts.
A lot of people don't know that. You know what I'm saying? I remember when, trust me, stuff like that happens. You know what I'm saying?
So when you sign to be an organ donor, can you change your mind towards that? Or once you sign, that's it?
That's a good question.
I'm not really sure.
Uh-huh. You're for selective service.
Now what it is?
I'm organs on it now. I'm scared.
No. Back. I'm just showing you what's gonna happen. Now you want your organs to effectively go to somebody that needs them.
Right.
But what you want
even
is
that in itself sound crazy.
No, what you want is like I don't know if I want that. I don't know if that's me being selfish. But as far as if you decide to be an organ donor, it should be because of the fact that you want somebody that's in need to have it. Mm-hmm. But you don't want their money to supersede the actual need. Mm-hmm. You don't want the fact that they have money be the fact that they can get it before somebody else that doesn't have money. So once something like that is regulated, it's something that I'll be a part of. You know, but effectively, all these missing children that we're talking about is not based on the organ donor system. It's based on the black market.
Fact.
You know what I'm saying? And what's happening is organ donor, but it's slave trafficking.
Even
because before they use the organs, they get money off of slave trafficking these young black girls, you know what I'm saying? And then sell their organs when they kill them. It's like, you know what I'm saying? It's like they do, you know, it's a snack after hours, man. You know what I'm saying? This shit is just so serious. And we want to open up the mind state of everybody. You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to get that little feeding that you don't know about all day.
I think to myself the other day, this is probably one of the biggest reasons why they kill and have the war on the minorities as black people. Because is it in the organs? After they die, they take the organs and do what they do with it? Like,
yeah. Yeah, I think this has been going on through all the world wars. You know, I think stuff like this been.
And also the her name, Hillary Clinton, the Pizzagate shit with them. We call it hiring all type of escorts, and they do all type of spirit cooking and devilish.
Now that been in play. Donald Trump's wife was an escort. You know what I'm saying?
No, but I mean, that's all.
That's
even,
that's what's even going on with the whole
but not,
shit.
Not regular female escorts.
Right.
I'm talking about young kids and
yeah. But you know, it's been
they was doing escorts with regular escort. They doing young kids and
yeah, nah. You know, it's all that sex
that
trafficking.
Is real right now.
You know what I'm saying? But we want to know that. We want to let y'all know that what's going on in D.C. is something that if we're not paying attention to, that's probably happening to in a lot of other states.
Fact.
You know what I'm saying? every state. You know what I'm saying? Fuck the states. If you remember in Africa, those 40 girls that they had that they trafficked them to through the jungle, and half of them died through malaria and snake bites and shit like that. What you think they was taking them girls for? They were still even trying to pull the dead bodies with them. Like, what you think is going on? Like, you know what I'm saying? But we can't live in a box and really not know what's going on and shit. So
think about money.
That's what I was gonna say.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, that's a
Rockefeller died what, a couple days ago, 101 years old? That man had 9 heart transplants.
Wow.
Now like what Mike Ford just said. Rockefeller died a couple years ago. He had 9 heart transplants.
Wow. Nigga, you know I don't want to live that long.
I bet they still I bet they still froze him or some shit like that. You know what I'm saying?
He got his consciousness in the USB. He got his consciousness in the USB.
That's crazy.
Is it move like that?
Yeah,
it's a move like that. Hours. You heard? That's word. What's that movie, Malio?
Chappy. He said he got his consciousness.
You can download consciousness. USB. This came out like a couple years ago. We had movies being downloaded your consciousness into a computer to where your brain's alive. I was watching a show called Black Mirror where basically the girl downloaded her consciousness into the computer and her real self is in the computer. Her fake self is out in the world and her real self is working for a fake self out in the world. And she's trapping it forever.
They done got niggas lost, man. I mean, niggas got lives on the internet, man. Niggas got different lives on the internet. Shit is going crazy, man. What else we got going on?
We'll go into a couple more songs.
Sorry to get all serious on y'all, but listen, y'all have to be conscious. You know what I'm saying? We do music and shit, but you know what I'm saying? The Snacks After Hours. It's real conversations, real situations. You know what I'm saying? Real people and real music, man.
Before you go to the top of my SoundCloud joint, I'll see how profile go to.
Yeah, and the joints you just heard Chop Shop, Des Diamond, Sleepy Hollow, that's the last joints you played. We played No Love and all that, you know what I'm saying? Y'all like that Biggie Smalls joint. That's real, that's real. What's it called?
Oh yeah, you gotta give him that piece of hit.
Yeah, we're gonna release that piece of hit a little later and all that and shit. You know what I mean? Yeah, we're going into a break, man. Shout out, man. Snacks After Hours, powered by Success Radio and Success Clothing NYC.
Yeah, man.
Shoot birds with a hit New York, let's bring the whole crew out. They feel amazed, I feel the same way about Holloway. Great survives when I write, isolate, hide for days. Once it surfaces, the circus strip purses with virgin lips at this pretty thick, treating like I'm deserving it. Got the workload, most people getting nervous and worship videos in your studios, call it perfect dish. For that to happen, had to make the right and permanent. City's making purchases, and tell me now, have you heard of it? Stakes away from home, not even bringing brass. Busy building connections, continuing to bridge the gap.
rush my doubt. I just left 16 ounces, came back with 32 more. I remember me and Charlie, we was sleeping on the floor. I ain't going back, there's no way I could get back and let it go. Get the butter and the toast until I pull up in a ghost. Free, free my nigga back, I hold the fence and let him go. Free, free, free my nigga, go to hold the fence and let him go. I be flipping work with the pack on me. Couple niggas send it back on me. Frontin' like they got the drop on me. Yo, that pump faking shot, homie. I don't fuck with niggas, none of y'all for me. I was down, they ain't had a pack for me. Getting money, none of y'all for me. I be getting money, I got a rack on me. Bad bitch to make it clap for me. She be in the hood, hold the dope for me. Kill yourself, come by the rope for me. Daddy used to sell crack for me. Hook it up, smoke for me. Let me know if it's good money. Then I hit the block, the big 20s. I fuck good, and I get money. I kill a nigga, try to take it from me. I don't fuck with niggas, they fake money. Couple niggas that is sick money. Got a couple bitches selling pussy for me. Couple youngins make it hot for me. Couple dollars shoot the block for me. Couple kings gotta die for me. Cop back, ride for me.
I got white, I got tans, I got zans, I got dope. I got white, I got tans, I got zans, I got dope. I got white, I got tans, I got zans, I got dope. I got white, I got tans, I got zans, I got dope.
Free all of my niggas. See me with the name, my triggers. Boom, boom, don't get it twisted like my fingers. They wild niggas that eat you like the now, nigga. Judge X, I'm in the now, nigga. Lead the fifth, but I rep the six. Ain't no cash rules like method, bitch. I'm on it all day. Shootouts in broad day. So work in the hallway. I lick at it like foreplay. This here, this murder music. Pick beat, I murder music. Bitch, thinking that life a better. My fuck up, double, now they confused with. My actions, I'm malmented. My chain bling like wild hazards. Yellow ice like mellow wife. Always round that la la. Get it off 448. Prefer to die, but I grip the weight. Good pussy, I prefer to face. Fuck your album, I prefer to tape. Cause I'm about that real shit. Diamond dance, that real shit. VVS, never see me stress. I tongue it block in a CVS. That's man's hands and Percocets. Need an engineer, but I work the tech. All black like Bruce Wayne. This neighborhood is so cool, gang.
Keeping exclusive with Back to the Future, Mac with the Ruger, like Don Kelly, feel like Boy George.
Turn the booster to a booster. When Uber's in the Uber, she hitting high notes like Luther. Yeah. Everything suits. Turn the booster to a booster. Maneuvers in the Uber, she hitting high notes like Luther. Yeah. Everything super. More money, more problems. Big told me I got them. Got shooters for your shooters. Foundations when I spot them. More shells than pasta. Bloodline of monsters. Leave the roof for your coop full of lobster. Everything super. Couple bands, I maneuvers. I'm a winner's never losers. These waters, I'm a scooper. Next to flippers to the jeweler. Look like with the ruler. Them, I'm with the sugar, but that nigga's so cooler. I'm a dirt bucket. I love it. Stacks in my arms covered. Niggas fixing mom covered. Yeah, white, I'm a covered. She broke it, she pawned shit. On the back of the corner shit. Got the big courier, pack shit, I be on money trips. Hurry up, grab the drinks. Damn, I be with the shit. Money's the topic, and niggas don't got it, and diamonds on top of it. Just made another flip. Nigga, we get rich. Everything soup. Turn the booster to a booster. Maneuvers in the Ubers. She hit high notes like Luther, yeah. Everything soup. Turn the booster to a booster.
Snacks here.
After hours, Success Radio.
The little meter went up, it popped, it went back down. Yeah. That's far.
Listen, there's a performance tonight. What's
shout out to V, the other V. She got a performance in the Builders down on Block and Prospect.
Okay, okay. That shorty that run around with Dip Squad, right?
Dip Squad. 7:30 Dip.
You know what it is right now. Snacks After Hours.
Shout out to Killer, man.
Yeah, shout out to Killer. Whole Dipset.
Hey, Joel's got a new album. I heard that joint Migos with Migos D. That shit fire.
Oh, that shit fire. On front, that the way out, he went on it. He really, really, really killed that, man.
This nigga, what his name?
Jim Jones. He was all right on
Jim
the
Jones.
Joint.
Right,
let me keep it 100. You know what I'm saying?
Migos and what's his name? Since that thing, nigga York, King York got new beat mixtape.
Yeah, shout out to King York.
So who phones that?
Stop the phone, bro.
Damn, Emilio. Emilio had a moment.
Shout out to DJ Emilio.
Emilio had a moment.
Yo, listen. So,
Emilio, what happened?
Yeah, he had a moment just now. You know what I'm saying? He heard one of his beats, and he had to let the beat play all the way through. He said, "Yo, I got it."
I thought you was in your own. We call it your Gandhi, Buddha shit.
Nah, you know what I'm saying?
He felt that zen at that moment.
he in the stage right now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because he been doing this shit. Shout out for Melio and shit.
As well.
You know, we got the pieces hitting done by Melio and
shit.
Yeah, shit
is crazy. I can't wait to hit the airways. It's in York. Got the beat mixtape. Shout out to York.
Yeah,
King York.
After that.
On that piff. Got a couple of joints on there. You know, we going to run through that. As well. Oh,
definitely, man. Definitely.
Got too much sauce. That shit's crazy.
Oh,
what else is going on?
So much. I gotta get. Yeah, shout out, York. We coming to see you soon, York.
That's part of 10 hours.
Matter of fact, you know we got a couple of things to finish working on, York, for real.
Facts.
Yeah, man.
What else is going on in past couple of weeks, B?
Man, the past couple of weeks, man. Like we really got serious just now, man. But with the rap game, it seems like everybody is up in the air taking a shot. I just can't wait because it's like it feel like it been week to week to hear some other shit that been going on. But I'm waiting to hear not the violence, not somebody getting robbed, you know what I'm saying? Not somebody beefing with somebody. But I'm waiting. Oh, J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They taking shots back and forth. That's
J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar?
Yeah.
Now, me personally, I feel Kendrick Lamar is nicer than J. Cole. I'll give it to Kendrick, but I gotta hear what he's talking about.
I didn't feel that way, but I think my opinion I can't really say that because I haven't really heard enough Kendrick Lamar. And then I heard a Kendrick Lamar song. I can't really remember what the name of the song was, but that shit was fire.
Yeah.
That shit was so fire. It was so fire. J. Cole, I like what J. Cole is doing because his consciousness is being awakened while he's entering the rap game at a further progress. So, you know what I'm saying? I like the fact of how his joint is changing up.
Now, he's definitely a conscious rapper. He got that Tupac aspect of a poet in him, but that Kendrick Lamar nigga, he's a problem.
You know, he's definitely a problem.
He's somebody that niggas don't got lyrically. He got lyrical flow, culture.
That's tough.
He has the poetry shit. He has all the pieces that you need.
Nah, it's a fact.
That's one person that, you feel me, that but even though I don't listen to his music, like, I don't like vibe out to his shit, but
The similarities with the two of them is both of them is like transcending off of like the a book bag rapper.
A backpack rapper,
excuse me. You know what I'm saying? Snacks After Hours, Success NYC, Success Clothing NYC, by Success Radio, right? You know what I'm saying? So it's just the fact that, you know, they really people that, you know, write.
Yeah.
And got bars, got lyrics and shit like that. So they always working on their joints. So I think for that similarity that they both have, it'll be one of the most craziest battles if they start going back and forth with each other. Because I think it'll really take to a lot of different stuff. You know what I mean?
They both talented individuals as well. Yo, we here, man. There's gonna be a lot of new episodes coming out. Old episodes gonna be new episodes. Stay in tune, man. Shit about to get real crazy.
You got that joint, Mike Foy?
You got it on his phone. Your man ready.
Ready.
You
gotta hook
that
joint up.
Close out, then we out to the showcase
snacks
after hours. If you ain't tuned in,
yeah, man.
Nothing.
Facts. Yeah, you gotta be tuned in, man. Gotta be tuned in.
It's on Bluetooth.
We gave you the live.
Nah, he got it. He got it on the plug-in. Listen,
man. You know how you gotta just make sure.
You remember the hook?
That's the right. You know how to introduce the song?
Damn.
Drop it.
This is Peace of Sentin, man. Dez Don, Sleepy Holloway.
My man said couple bars.
Oh, couple. Damn, Slum. I'm gonna hold you. I'm gonna shit a minute. Yo, hold on.
It's new to them, bro. It's new to them.
What'd that say? Couple guns, couple strips. Couple bricks. And a couple flips. Walking with your bitch.
Niggas wanna clap at me.
5.
Oldest bitches after me.
4.
Hit the club catastrophe.
3.
With your bitch.
Bag the bitch.
That's swipey, nigga.
2.
Fresh Joe, Tech Nike, nigga.
1.
The Tech with the Nike, nigga. With your bitch.
That note, we gonna throw it up to the new joint.
Yeah, you know.
Cash no way with my tools.
Come on, man.
Recent pick.
Missing. My piece is hitting, throwing traffic on the hard. I ain't talking crossing guard to the boss of enemy squad. Got me trapped on guard.
The graphics, yeah.
Y'all got Mike 40 doing y'all show.
Mike 40, shout out to Mike 40 Snacks After Hours.
Y'all got a photographer, a graphic designer.
Listen, we just had to premiere that a little while ago.
Y'all about to get y'all own studio, maybe, possibly, thank
God. Can't tell them
all that way. We back live.
Can't tell them the secrets.
You know. Listen, a lot of things going on. Yeah. Shout out to V12. Yeah. Shout out to a homegirl performing this shit. You know what I'm saying? It's about to be that time. We're about to get out of here. We got like one more joint to play or two more joints to play. We playing here right now.
Shout out to
we just wanted to do that and shit. You know what I mean? Just
put that what you call that super.
Everything's super.
Yeah, that's fine.
They don't even know, man.
Shout out to Billy, man.
Snacks After Hours.
Super duper. Shout out to all them super.
Money and
trappers,
power.
Man.
Yeah.
All them dudes out there getting it, man. We out there snacking. Yeah. There's diamonds. Hollow. Guns, money,
yeah, we're about to get out here, Billy. I see you.
New City promo.
We permitting a couple of beats. Yes, sir.
Turn the booster to a booth. Maneuvers in the Ubers.
to hit that